decided you wanted to find the perfect waifu. Maybe you got in an argument with a friend and wanted to see whose is better. Where do you even start? What archetype should she be? What should her relationship to the main character be? Does cuteness matter? How much? All these and more will be answered today with Project Yamagata. Now, every waifu can be broken down into four base elements. The kawaii coefficient, K, the depth determiner, Q, for quality, disposability, D, and the thought factor, T. There may be as yet undiscovered other elements of waifu composition, but for now, these work well enough. And because these factors can be modeled by functions, it's possible to optimize them and using calculus to determine the maximum and minimum of the appropriate subfunctions, and by extension, the perfect waifu. Let's start with kawaii coefficient. Ah yes, one last thing. This will be our master function. K times Q minus D over T equals W.
And now we have the kawaii coefficient. The kawaii coefficient is a measure of a waifu's cuteness. Now a waifu typically has proportionately large forehead eyes with sparkling eyes and small chin and nose with small round cheeks. Now, the kawaii coefficient is a ratio of X equals S F times E times R over CN. And now you enter in all your values into that to get your kawaii coefficient. Now to find the optimum point on this, we have the equation negative 1/2 x squared plus 5x minus 2.5. Now once you derivatize this, it's k of x prime of x equals negative x plus 5. And now optimization is where you need to find the utmost point on this, and that would be when k prime of x equals 0. That value is when k prime of x equals 0 is 5. So that means that the ratio for the kawaii coefficient would equal 5 to make to produce the correct kawaii coefficient of 10.
And now for disposability. Disposability is pretty simple, and it's essentially asking how basic do she be. This is determined by the percent similarity she has to her archetype, whether that be tsundere or yandere or deridere, whatever. That will be your x, and your y will be given by the basic function d of x equals x. And as a result, your derivative will be d prime of x equals 1, and as a double result of that, your minimum value and your ideal value will be at 0, which is our interval because of the nature of percentage similarities. You want this to be as low as possible, so 0.
This is thought factor. Thought factor is the measure of how much of a thought your waifu is. So your x value is composed of the average husbandos per year, inversely with her chances for abandon, displayed by this equation right here, 1 over age, the integral from 0 to age of the significant others per year. Now, that can be put into the thought equation, which is T of x equals E 1/2 of x. Now, the derivative of that is T prime of x equals 1/2 e to the 1/2 x. Now our optimal value for this is that x equals 0, the thought factor equals 1. So our optimal value is equal to 0. And it is not possible for the thought factor to equal 0 because if she breathes,
fine, death determined. The most important and complicated part of the entire formula. This is made up of several smaller factors known as characterization criteria, thickness value, smile supplement, archetype affiliation, age affection, and family factor, known as C, T, S, big A, little a, and F, respectively. Characterization criteria is essentially an amalgamation of screen time, quality of character, character development, etc. The maximum of this will be 10, because at a certain point they become the main character and you can't really know anything more about them. This is a bit tricky because to a certain extent, a lot of mystery, for example, can make a character more interesting, but for the most part you want the audience to know, and the experimenter, essentially, to know basically who they're dealing with. So ideally this will be a character that the audience knows very well, but still has new and interesting things that can be developed. You know, like a proper waifu. Excuse me. Essentially, how well developed are they out of 10? Simple enough. Thickness value. Thickness of what? Well, thickness of support for their personality, of course. Duh. This represents your X value, the support they receive from the ground. Plug that into your equation. 5t squared minus 5t all over t squared. And as this approaches infinity, the limit of this is around 5. This is because as you achieve the limits of what is possible, how much support does a personality need, after all, it becomes less and less beneficial. But ideally, you want this to be as high as possible, which will be 5. Smile supplement. How would you rate their smile out of 5? 0, 2, 5. You want this as high as possible, so 5. Archetype affiliation is asking how much you like her archetype. Yes or no? 0.5 if no. 1 if meh. 2 if okay and weary. Family factor represents how her score is harmed by familiar relationships to the main character, and it's a divisor score, so it's on the bottom of our master function. So you want this to be as low as possible, but not 0. Now, if she is blood family, she's your blood fam squad, then this is a 0, so this would all be over 0, because out of the question. Step fam, yeah, okay, it's fine. It's a bit creepy, but, you know, it's not incest. Anyway, cousins, S is the degrees of separation, and your equation for your X value is 10e to the negative S plus 1 equals F. That will give you your family factor. The lowest you can reasonably expect this to be, well, the lowest it can be and still not be 0, is 1. That's what you want. Age affection represents how her score is harmed by the creepiness caused in difference in age between her and the main character who's representing you. Now, this is going to be a divisor on the bottom of our master function, so we want this to be not 0, but low. And this is pretty simple. It's old over young. However, if she looks to be young, but is actually in excess of 100 years old, then just assume a 1. Because, you know, she's technically 18. See additional resources for optimal phrasing of she's 18, officer, I swear. Your ideal value for this and your minimum will be 1. Now, for your final equation, it will be given by this. Archetype affiliation, all times, characterization criteria, plus thickness value, plus smile supplement, all over age affection, times family factor. That will give you your X value, which you then plug into the equation E to the 1/5 x, which gives you your q of x. Now, the maximum value you can get for your x, we work out to be around 40. And a value of 40 for this would give you a final y value of approximately 3,000, give or take about 50. This is the meat and potatoes of a good waifu, so you should do this last. But yes, your optimum value will be about 2950. Now for some lightning round examples. You think this is pretty decent, right? No. Her name is Amelia. Wrong.
This is the superior one. Her name is Rem because she gets better character development in the second season, and her smile is better. She has an actual character. What else? She's the generic can do no wrong. Rem has flaws, but unending devotion. So, Rem is clearly the superior. What about this? These two. Everyone knows these two. Sayori responds. You think that that Sayori would be better with some surprising depth from having spoilers? But Monica pulls ahead, being in love with the play, not just the main character. So as a result, the Kawhi coefficient from Sayori and the smile element just don't make up for the lead that the character development gave Monica. And it makes sense. Why can't we find the ideal though? Determined to find it, because the math checks out. It makes sense. But after watching countless shows, finding countless potential candidates, it would have to be. No, that doesn't make any sense. Like, depth is supposed to be supporting. Why? But they're like at odds or something. Why? They're supposed to help each other. Kawhi coefficient. Disposability, depth determinant, thought factor—they're all supposed to work in tandem. But Kawhi, disposability and thought are fine, but Kawhi and depth are at odds. Why? It doesn't make any sense. Why the numbers? What do they? I keep hearing the freaking numbers. What do they mean? Like.
Formulas, optimization, going back through the numbers, over through the numbers again. We went back to the master formula. We plugged in all the numbers, and the only character able to express all of these equations and optimization, the only possible character out of around 30,000 maximal optimization on here for the W, I'm just as surprised as you are. The most perfect waifu. Waluigi!
And now for disposability. Oh shit, it's still all written. Finally. Characterization criteria. Fuck.